you got to have your rest. She says, come lay beside me, I've been waiting since you left.
John and Hannah, have you come here to enter into a marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I am.
I, John. Take you, Hannah.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. I, Hannah. Take you, John.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
Hannah,
receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. John, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
John, you may kiss your bride.
I first knew John as Hannah's date to the Christmas dance in 8th grade, then for a few years as her friend. Then he was Hannah's friend with the Luke Skywalker haircut that asked her to junior prom. The summer following that, he seemed to be at our house every single day, and so by the end of that summer, I found it safe to call him her boyfriend. 5 years later, he became her fiancé, and today, a little over a year later, her husband. And officially my brother. Although he's already been a brother to me and the rest of my siblings for much longer than that. John, Hannah, I love you both. And I'm so excited for you to start this new chapter of your lives together. This time, I'd like everyone to raise their glasses. Kids, raise up your lemonade and cheers to the bride and groom.
My parents and John's parents live about 5 minutes away from each other, or 2 minutes as the bird flies, John always says. He would text me and be like, I'm on my way, and I would be sitting there waiting for 35 to 40 minutes. But when it came to Hannah, that was drastically different. I would wake up on Friday, and his side of the room would be vacuumed, packed. He would have everything ready to go home for the weekend, and the rumor is he didn't even shut his truck off during his last class of the week. Before I finally shut up and stop talking, I would just like to give you a little piece of advice from one married man to another. So Hannah, if you could place your hand on top of the table, and John, place your hand on top of hers. John, this will be the first and last time you have the upper hand in your relationship. With that being said, could everyone please raise their glasses and toast for a lifelong journey together for two people I consider great friends, John and Hannah Steen.